Hello friends, as you can see right now, I'm using Kali Linux. I have installed this in my Android device and my device is not rooted too. You can also install Kali Linux in your Android device without rooting it. So today in this video, I will tell you how you can install Kali Linux in your Android device without rooting it. To install Kali Linux, you will require 3 applications, Andronix, Tomox and VNC Viewer. I have given Play Store link of these applications in description. You can install it by clicking there or by simply searching on Play Store. After downloading these applications, first open Andronix. If you will open it for first time, it will ask for choose DIM. You can select any DIM you want and you can see here Linux distros like Ubuntu, Kali Linux. If you will click on any of them for first time, limitations of Android message will pop up. If you want to, you can read about that and if you don't, just close it. So here is Ubuntu, that red one is Debian and the black one is Kali. To install this, simply click on install. Again, if you want to, you can read documentation. After that, see here in install section, you can see 3 options for desktop environment, XFCE, LXD, LXQT. You can install anyone from these 3 variants. And for non-desktop environment, you can install Kali from non-desktop environment section. If you will click on anyone from these 3 or 4 options, you will see a message, code has been copied, open Tomox. Click on it, no matter if you click on non-desktop or anyone from desktop environment. If you will paste the code that we have copied from Andronix here, Kali Linux installation process will be started. But right now we are in home directory. So I will make a separate folder or directory in which I will install Kali Linux. So I am going to create a directory named Linux distro by mkdir command. And then in that directory, I will create another directory named Kali Linux. So that the files for installing this will be stored in separate directory. Let me change my directory to Kali Linux by cd command. So you can see that this is an empty directory and by giving pwd command, you can see that I am in Kali Linux directory. Here I will paste the command that was copied to our clipboard by Andronix. By holding anywhere on screen, select paste button. After pasting it, press enter. So in desktop environment, there were 3 options, XFCE, LXD and LXQT. From those 3, I selected XFCE. Why? Because XFCE variant is more stable and customizable as compared to other 2 variants. So I would suggest you to select the XFCE variant or if you want to try another variants, you can install them too in another directory. This will take almost 30 minutes to install and will require 1 GB of data for this. You don't have to do anything, just leave your phone for 30 minutes. My internet speed was about 1 Mbps so it took 30 minutes for me. If your speed is high, it will complete it in less than 30 minutes or if it is low, then it will take more time. I trimmed the installation part because you don't have to do anything there, it will automatically download required files. After the installation finishes, you will see a message like this, welcome to Andronix Kali. This means that the Kali Linux is now successfully installed in your device. Now if I will do ls here, you will see 2 directories and a file. By using pwd command, you can see that I am in the same directory in which we pasted that command. Here we have to run startkali.sh file. For that, type .slash and start-kali.sh. You see the root at localhost, that means now Kali Linux is running in your Tomox, but this is only command line interface. If you want to run graphical interface, for that you have to start a VNC server. And we are going to connect to VNC server by VNC Viewer app. To run VNC server, type VNC server and hit enter. It will ask you to set a password. For example, here I will enter 12345. Nope, it must be 6 characters long. So I will enter 123456 this time. Type again to verify it. Now it's asking, if you would like to enter view only password, type N for no and our VNC server is now successfully started. You see that here it is written IS21. That means the server is started at localhost IS21. So if you will open VNC server for first time, you will see something like this. Just click on next, next, again next and at last click on get started. Here click on plus button in address section, write localhost IS21 and in name section you can write anything. Here I will write Kali and then click on connect. If there will be a warning like this about unencrypted connection, just click on OK. After that, you will need to enter password that you chose while running VNC server for first time. In my case, it was 123456 and click on continue. A message will pop up on how to control the computer. If you want to see tutorial, click on next, else click on skip button. Kali Linux is running, but there is some issue named fail to execute child process dbus launch no such file or directory. This type of error will happen for you too. If you will install XFCE variant from Andronix. So how to fix it? Close this message and open your Tomox again. Here you have to install a package. So give command apt-get space install space dbus dash x11 and hit enter. After the installation process of this package finishes, switch back to VNC Viewer application. Here disconnect this by clicking on X button, and let's try to connect it again to see if this problem is fixed or not. Again we see a blank black screen and nothing else. So disconnect it again and switch back to Tumux. Here we need to kill the running VNC server. For that type VNC server space dash kill is to space is to 1. We wrote is to 1 because it was running on localhost is to 1. So this will kill the first port, and you can see that it has been successfully killed. Again start the VNC server by typing VNC server start. Oh, I forgot, we don't have to write start. Just type VNC server and hit enter. VNC server is up again at port 1. Switch back to VNC viewer and connect again by selecting Kali and click on OK for unencrypted connection. Here we see a blank screen again. But now we got a mouse pointer. That means that this is the first time, so it is taking some time to start. As you can see now Kali Linux is up and running successfully. You can zoom in like you do in Pix, and if auto rotate is on, turn your phone to landscape mode and you can view like this. Here if you will click on pin, the toolbox will be hidden. Now this is hidden and we are in full screen mode now. You can move mouse pointer by sliding on screen. Let's go in application section and open terminal here. This is Kali Linux terminal. If you write any command here or in Tumux at root at localhost, both are same. So when you want to use only terminal, then use Tumux, and if you want to run a package that has GUI, you can use this. Now terminal is running and working fine and there is no issue. Now let's try to use browser in Kali Linux. I installed CMatrix to make sure that terminal is running fine or not. You can install and run it too. Now we will check the browser. I trimmed the part in which I was installing CMatrix because everyone knows how to do it. See, this is Firefox browser in Kali and it's working fine. Not only Kali Linux, you can install any other Linux distros from Andronix just like this. It is very simple. If you encounter any issues while installing or running it, write it in comment section. I will try to reply you as soon as possible. That's it for this video. I will see you in next one.